if I, it's the starting of the month, I have salary in my account. So I will prefer at that time Starbucks. But if it is like the month is ending, it will be Sardarji Baksh in that case, I guess.
So after knowing what people believe, we came to know that everyone would rather choose a local coffee shop upon Starbucks to enjoy a sip of coffee with a chilled mind without going after a brand to click picture for social media to maintain what we know as the social status or the high status. Well, some even said that Starbucks give them the taste of their choice. But is this enough for this overly expensive cappuccino latte to make its place amongst the Indian market? Let's figure this out together.
History and how it came in India. An inviting sign in a 6 dialects: Hindi, Marathi, Tamil, Gujarati, French, and English, welcomes clients at the passage of India's first Starbucks store, which opened Friday at Honeyman Circle in South Bombay, offering a brief look at the conferment that the Tata Gathering and Starbucks Corporation are endeavoring. The environment is on target. Newly cooked espresso is fragrant. The stylish theme is recognizably Indian. The cups are decorated with Starbucks India alongside a picture of India Gate. Iron trunks and jute sacks stamped with the Tata Coffee Limited line the divider. Around the world, Starbucks has 18,000 cafes in 60 nations. It has 700 in China, 800 in UK, and 1,000 in Japan. A limited menu is an absolute necessity in India, as food is a significant piece of cafe culture. In its 40 years history, India is the main area where Starbucks is sourcing and roasting its espresso locally. A sign in the shop says, "Be set up to be enchanted. Our rich espresso made with espresso beans, filled in India, for India." The coordinated food market, which incorporates high-end food, speedy health eateries, bistro chains, is a $2 billion market, of which the cafe business. For example, it comprises chains like Cafe Coffee Day, Costa Coffee, and Barista, which is now a $230 million market. As per an October report by Technopack Advisors, a retail consultancy firm, roller coaster experience of Starbucks after its grand entry in India.
After Starbucks opened its first store in India in Mumbai, they opened their first roasting and packaging plant to supply its Indian outlets in Karnataka. Tata Starbucks grew its presence in Delhi on 24 January 2013 by opening 2 outlets. Gradually, they announced that they would have 50 locations by the end of 2013 with Rs 4 billion in their hands. But the company opened its 50th store in India on 8 July 2014. The third city where the popular foreign outlet Starbucks built in was Pune on 8 September 2013. The luxury brand Starbucks opened its largest coffee outlet in the country in Bangalore on 18 March 2019.
Starbucks announced its entry into Gujarat City on 7 August 2019. And the very next day, they simultaneously opened 5 stores in Surat and Ahmedabad. In Gujarat, they focus more on vegetarian options than other Indian outlets. Surat stores have been designed to reflect the city's rich historical culture while presenting a deep coffee passion. After growing in speed, the company spread out in the whole country with its 170 outlets and the first in Vadodara in December 2019. After the enormous expansion of outlets and designing the luxury ambience and menu, the customer was too posh and too high in rates.
The like in case of Starbucks, you have a choice what kind of variant of coffee exactly you want. So that's one kind of a thing that I don't think is possible when we are going to a regional coffee shop. Like if I want extra short and espresso, or I want my espresso to be mild, I can do it in Starbucks.
Due to the high price of the food and beverages, the coffee lovers and the people who just go for chilling and making their delight with coffee started comparing the facilities and the taste of Starbucks coffee from other local coffee shops. And the crowd, which was too excited after the announcement of a foreign brand coming in India with something new, gradually started vanishing from the stores towards their local coffee shops for better taste and same facilities as Starbucks.
After seeing a significant loss in all these years, Starbucks realized that Indians want more of Indian flavor food and drinks, and the American Starbucks menu was way too sweet for Indians. It backfired, and Starbucks started to offer a blend of international and Indian cuisines and developed its own uniqueness by transforming the menu according to Indians and their taste. The idea of giving desi tadka to their international cuisines, they also offer tandoori paneer roll. They have also created a delightful mix of premium coffee house muffins, cookies, and the custom menu items with unique Indian flavors for India. Well, Starbucks have also innovated Tata Tazo for Indians now.
And they also decided to come up with new ideas to attract the Indians. In developing their uniqueness, they always do something new or unique, from announcing proudly that they are opening some of the stores which are exclusively operated by women. Like this, Starbucks created more opportunities for women. In 2019, CEO Gurnani announced that the Tata Starbucks would transition to use only compostable and recyclable packaging material across all its stores from June 2020. But by putting lots of effort and trying to come up with the goodies, they cannot sell their food in the Indian market. Starbucks stated that their strategy would be guided by the consumers and not by competition. Even in the case of pricing, they will be driven by consumers, but their prices are not affordable by the Indians.
Now the hurdle that is coming in their path is their pricing, of course, taste of coffee and obesity, the growing obesity basically. Coffee drinkers even say that most of the hot drinks contain more than 20 teaspoons of sugar. And as we all know, Indian from the south loves to drink coffee. The passion for coffee is so real that even the localites say that they get better taste coffee on the local coffee shop than Starbucks.
Well, even though Starbucks came to India with a lot of thoughts in their mind to win over the hearts of the Indians, they failed terribly. Starbucks somehow lost the war in India against the local shops serving their hearts in every coffee they serve.
Starbucks prefer करोगे या local coffee shop?
Local coffee shop.
क्यों?
क्योंकि वहाँ का जो उसका price है वो थोड़ा costly है यहाँ के comparison में.
Even after almost 6 years, the joint venture by Tata Group and Starbucks International has not yet backed down. They made sure that each store has its own unique vibe and presence in the country. But they did fail to execute it. So, where did Starbucks fail?
So Nikhil, if I give you an option between two coffee shops, be it Starbucks and a local coffee shop, so which one would you prefer?
I will prefer local coffee shop.
Why? There should be a reason, right?
Because in Starbucks, it's so costly, and it's the main reason that why Starbucks fail in India.
Okay.
The main purpose of Starbucks that it was famous is that it give your name on back of its coffee cup.
Okay.
That why it got and people post it on their social media and it got so famous.
Mm-hmm.
But in India, there is no one like who can pay so much of money just for their name, and because they can get same coffee at another shop now.
Okay.
Let me share with you one of my personal experience with Starbucks for why I believe Starbucks failed in India. Recently, I visited Starbucks store to get know more about their marketing strategies and their experience with the Indian audience. But I was shocked to find out that the employees there were quite irresponsible. The shop manager gave me the number of customer care in the head of marketing department, of course, but it was all worthless. No one responded. Also, one of the customers asked me why I was there and also said if it is regarding some refund issues or something. Then the customer care guys are never going to answer the call. This clearly shows how irresponsible Starbucks is. Even the customers are not satisfied by the services that they provide. According to the report of Kotak Institutional Equities, each Starbucks store makes almost ₹93,000 per day in 2020. They even have 425 customers per day, which has been increasing day by day. Thus, they make around 30 lakhs per month. But there is a drawback that they are facing. One Starbucks store shells out almost 6 lakhs per month for their rent only. Thus, the company has been reducing the store size since 2019 to meet its ends. Not just the rent, the company is also paying for the employees and raw materials because they don't want to tamper with their quality just because of the profit. Well, Starbucks did have a huge brand value in India, and Indians are opting for the high-rated brand for using it as a status symbol only. Some social media posts and the tags are what comes to the mind of Indian customers when they first think of Starbucks. But despite of all the rough and tough social media game, Starbucks failed to woo the biggest marketing tool ever. Customers, of course.